Hello guys, welcome back to Championship Predictions. We are back for some more big juicy championship games and I'm joined by Sophie. How are you?
Yes, very well, thank you. How are you?
Not too bad. Let me just explain to the viewers what is happening with today's video. Because it's FA Cup fourth round weekend, the fixture list has been broken up somewhat, but there is still seven championship games over the next 7 days. Some of them being as soon as tomorrow, Leeds v Norwich. That's why this video is coming out early. We've also got games at the weekend, and we've also got games at the start of next week as well. All of them will be included in today's video. Before we get into the predictions for those games, guys, please do make sure to drop a like on this video and show it some support. Let's go for a nice round target of 1,000 likes. If you've not already hit the like button, make sure to do so. It's free to do, so there's no point not hitting the like button. Get involved, click the like button, and also make sure to subscribe. As you can see, we are so close to 55,000 subscribers. We are slowly getting there. If you're one of the people that haven't subscribed yet, we need you. Hit that subscribe button. The scores on the doors quickly, Sophie. You did beat me in the championship predictions, 9-7. Some good points scored there. Mm-hmm. And that means that I'm still in front, but my lead has been slashed to 1 point.
Come on, need to have a good weekend.
Yes.
Or well, week.
I need to better your predictions here, Sophie. You're going to overtake me. Let's kickstart it then, Sophie, with Wednesday's game. The game coming tomorrow as the day we've released this. And it's a big one, Sophie. Leeds United versus Norwich City. Oof. Both sides are coming into this on a couple of good results. Leeds United, Sophie, they just about found a way against Preston 2-1.
I did think it'd be a little bit more convincing, but still a win.
Yeah, and to be honest, it's revenge, isn't it? Because Preston scored late on against them on Boxing Day.
They did, yeah.
Leeds United just need to keep winning. The 3 points is the most important thing. They've already got a better goal difference than the teams around them. Just keep chucking on points. However it comes, they need to win this game. But Norwich City are not going to take it lying down. They picked up a great 2-0 win against West Brom.
They did.
And this has become difficult for me, Sophie, because before Norwich City's game against West Brom, which I had backed a draw for, a Norwich fan had been saying to me in the comments, you don't back Norwich very much. And do you know what? Maybe they have gone under my radar somewhat, because all of a sudden they find themselves really, really close to the playoffs. Mm-hmm. And when it comes to quality, I think they could get in there. That said, Leeds United have one of the best teams in the league. What do you reckon, Soph? Daniel Farke derby. I'm going to say Leeds 2-1 again.
Yeah.
I think Norwich will make it really close, but Leeds just find a way.
Yeah, I was tempted to say a Leeds 3-1 win, but when I went quite heavy for Leeds last time, they did let me down slightly on the scoreline. So I'm going to agree with you. I think 2-1 Leeds. But I feel like Norwich are going to make it a really difficult game. Leeds' home form cannot be ignored. They've not lost at home all season, so it'd be a big ask for Norwich to go there and do that. Could well get a draw. I don't see it happening. Leeds 2-1 for me.
Leeds 2-1. Yeah, both going for the same prediction there. Both back in Leeds to just get past Norwich. Share your thoughts on that game. Big game at Elland Road. Next up, Sophie, and we're going to go to the Den, where Millwall take on Preston North End. Both sides lost at the weekend, Sophie. They both lost on the road. Preston went away to Leeds. They took the lead after 65 seconds, by the way, to then lose it about 65 seconds from the end. Millwall, they lost 2-0 to QPR. That was quite disappointing.
Yeah, a little bit of a shock to me, to be honest, because they haven't been in bad form.
Yeah, Millwall, just so inconsistent, but so are Preston. If they both keep going the way they have been recently, they're both going to end up in the middle of the table, let's be honest. Mm-hmm. Which wouldn't be too bad for Millwall, considering they started slower, but it wouldn't be great for Preston, because they started well.
Great start, yeah.
I'll tell you what, so if Millwall have a decent record against Preston over the last 8, 9, 10 games, and they're at home, let's go for a trusty Millwall 1-0.
Right, I'm actually going for a 1-1 draw here. At times, Preston do impress me. Equally, they frustrate me because I feel like at times they do underperform, but equally their league position for the beginning of the season, it was almost like a false position. And now they've dropped down a little bit. You feel like, is this where they're going to stay for the remainder of the season? Possibly, as you've mentioned, they are both quite inconsistent. So 1-1 for me.
Okay, yeah, I was so close to going that way, but we shall see. At least we've gone different there.
There we go.
I'm going for a Millwall win. Sophie's going for a draw. Next up, Soph, we're going to the Stadium of Light where Sunderland take on Stoke City. Do you know what? When I was listening to the Sunderland-Hull City game the other day, I don't think I've heard louder boos than when Sunderland lost that game to Hull City and the full-time whistle was blown. It's not looking good for Michael Beale.
No, I think they already won him out. I don't know why they appointed him in the first place. I think I said that in one of the videos.
Yeah. To be honest, it's still quite early, but...
It is, yeah.
Can you see him really making things a lot better? I suppose the only way he can do that is on the pitch, but even if they win their next two games, I don't think the Sunderland fans are still going to be totally happy, are they?
No, I don't think so.
I could see Sunderland winning this, but Stoke have been all right recently, except they did lose to Birmingham, which you did predict. You did also get told off by a Stoke fan for not backing them, but then again, you got your prediction right.
There we go.
Are you going to go for Stoke this week? I tell you what, I am. I'm going to back Stoke to win this game.
Okay.
I remember Stoke winning, was it 5-1 at Sunderland last year?
Jeez, I don't remember.
I don't think it'd be 5-1.
No.
But I think they will just edge it 2-1.
Oh, see, I'm going to say 1-1 again. I know that sounds really boring, but I do agree, actually, if you're going to lean towards any side here, I probably would lean more towards Stoke. Sunderland are the home side, and that's why I'm going to give them a point. But yeah, I could see your prediction playing out as well, but I'm gonna stick with mine and say 1-1.
1-1. Okay, right, Sophie, this is absolutely massive on the Sunday. We are heading to QPR versus Huddersfield. This is 22nd at home to 21st, and last week the gap between these two closed a little bit because QPR beat Millwall. Huddersfield, they keep plodding along with draws, don't they?
They do.
We did both back them to draw 1-1 at Blackburn, which is what they did.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised if this is 1-1.
No, I wouldn't be.
I think QPR need the win more. Of course, Huddersfield need the win to get away from them, but QPR are in a more desperate situation. I am really tempted to go for a draw. I don't know what it is. Huddersfield, they could be playing top of the league or bottom of the league, and they just find a draw.
Get a draw, yeah.
No. I want the relegation battle to spice up a bit. And just for that reason purely, I'm going to edge QPR. I think Huddersfield might stay up, you know, but they're making it difficult for themselves.
Yeah.
QPR 1-0.
Okay. So I'm going to go for another 1-1 draw. No, I'm joking. I'm actually going to pick a winner this time. Watch a 1-1 play out now, and I've shot myself in the foot. Wouldn't be that surprised with Darren draw, but I do see a little bit more fight in QPR, actually. So I'm going to back them to win 2-1.
Ooh.
I feel like it'd be 1-1 going into late stages and QPR just nicking it, getting 3 points.
Yeah, okay. Interesting.
So both going QPR.
Yeah, both going for QPR. That would really spice up the relegation battle.
Yeah.
Share your thoughts on that big game between QPR and Huddersfield. I genuinely don't know. I think it could be a draw, but we've both not gone for a draw. Next up, Sophie, we're going to move on to Tuesday's fixtures, and we start at the CBS, where Coventry City take on Bristol City. Now, of course, Coventry City and Bristol City will have both played in the FA Cup fourth round coming into this game, but we're recording that before that has played out. If we're going off league form, Sophie, Bristol City have been good, but Coventry City have been better.
Yeah.
Coventry are absolutely flying, and what matters here is 3 points, however it comes. Bristol aren't a bad side. You know, they're the kind of side that if you draw two on the road, you're not too heartbroken.
Yeah.
But we lost to them away from home, Sophie, and it was a game we really shouldn't have lost.
Yeah.
We really did, you know, we created so many good chances, and then we conceded a rubbish goal, and they beat us 1-0. I'm desperate to beat them to make up for that.
Yeah.
I'm going to go for the same scoreline, 1-0 to the home team. I think Coventry just edged this. As I say, keep the 3 points coming, however it comes. Sky Blues, 1-0.
Yeah, obviously the 3 points is the most important thing, but I would like a clean sheet as well, actually. I don't see it happening, you know. I'm going to back us to win. Sky Blues win 2-1 for me, but Bristol City aren't a bad team, can't be underestimated. So, yeah, I still think we're too good. We're going to win, yeah, 2-1. I had a moment there where I thought, could it be a draw possibly? But no, we win.
Confidence is running through our veins at the moment, Sophie, but we will get tripped up when we least expect it.
Yeah.
Yes or no, do Coventry make the playoffs?
Yes.
Yes.
No doubt about it.
On to the next one, Sophie. Let's go to the King Power, where Leicester City take on Swansea City. Now, Leicester have dropped points in their last couple of games. Need to get back to winning ways, especially with them playing this time and the likes of Southampton and Ipswich won't play these fixtures out until the end of February. They'll be catching up then. Yeah, I think they will win it, to be honest. Swansea are just... I don't know. They're not a bad side.
They're not bad.
They're not consistent.
Great either.
Yeah. They're just not very... Yeah. Yeah, they're just...
This is okay.
They're mid-table.
Yeah.
I'm going to go Leicester to win this 2-1. Maybe it's the fact that they're missing Fatawu and a couple of players to the Africa Cup of Nations, but they're not being totally convincing. I think they'll win, but they're not destroying teams at the moment. Leicester 2-1.
I was really tempted to say 1-1, actually. I wouldn't be that surprised if Swansea did get a draw. I'd be surprised if they got a win, but I wouldn't be that surprised if they... did get a last minute goal and walk away with a point. However, Leicester need to learn from their mistakes, and that's conceding late on and dropping points. And I feel like they might do it this game, actually. 1-0, but they're going to have to battle hard for it.
Yeah, it won't be straightforward. No. Yeah, interesting. Both going for the Foxes to get past the Swans there. Share your thoughts on that game. One game left to predict, Sophie, and it's next Wednesday's game between Sheffield Wednesday and Watford. Not easy to predict this, Sophie, because Sheffield Wednesday have been pretty good, but I think the thing is with them, they're not drawing many. No. They're winning and losing, if that makes sense. And that's fine, as long as, you know, there's a fair few wins in there. Mm. They need to, you know, get a result here because they didn't last time in the league against Coventry. QPR are playing Huddersfield, so one of those will at least be picking up points. And at home, you just wonder if Wednesday might get something. But Watford have been pretty good.
Yeah.
They always seem to score, but they always seem to concede. So could go for a bit of a Desmond here. But you know what? Let's spice up the relegation battle and give Sheffield Wednesday a much needed 3 points.
Okay.
Gonna go for Sheffield Wednesday 2-1.
Oh, I'm actually going 2-1 the other way. I'm saying it's going to be a tight game because Wednesday are at home and they aren't a bad team at home, actually. But Watford have been on the up. They're obviously eyeing up the playoff places. And they need to get a win here if they're looking to cement themselves in the playoff race anyway. I do see them doing it 2-1, but it's not going to be easy.
There you go. So you're back in Watford to get past Wednesday. There you go, guys. That wraps up our championship predictions for week 29, albeit only 14 of the 24 teams are in action because the FA Cup has kind of messed up the fixture list for this week. The teams that aren't in action for this next week and a bit, their games for this fixture list have been moved to late February, so they will be catching up then. But the 14 teams in action this week need to take advantage of these games they are playing out. So that wraps up the championship predictions, guys. As I say, share your predictions for the 7 games down in the comments. Make sure to hit the like button. It's free to do. 1,000 likes. Come on. It's free to do. Hit that like button. Are we going to hit it?
Yes, we are.
We are. And make sure to subscribe. It's also free to subscribe, and you will help us on the march to 55,000 subscribers. Thank you for joining me, Sophie.
Thank you.
We will see you guys in the next one. Take care. Peace out. Thank you for watching today's video, everyone. If you enjoy what you see here on the Matt SB channel, do make sure you are subscribed to the channel and hit the like button on every video we produce. If you really want to go one bit further and support the channel financially, then you can click the link down in the description to join the Matt SB Patreon page. If you click the link in the description, it will take you to it where you can financially support myself and Sophie on this channel monthly. You can join the 11 people we've already got that have signed up financially to the Patreon page and pay £3, £5 or £10 a month to support us. And the money we do get from Patreon goes towards things like improving the equipment on the channel, buying tickets to go to games, and so on and so forth. And you could cancel at any time. One thing myself and Sophie do want to do on the channel in 2024 is make merchandise for the Matt SB channel, and it would be available to the Patreons first. If you want to support us with our dream on YouTube, do be sure to head over. It's massively appreciated. Thank you for watching. We'll continue to pump out the videos. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.